Did you ever notice that sometimes, you know, you are turning, you know, the television and all of a sudden you come on EWTN and say, oh, this for the birds, and you shut it off? That's not you. That's the evil within us today. Because if you listen, it's going to do something, and that is going to hurt you. Because God said, my word is like a sword sharpened from both edges, that once entered the heart, that means you receive the word, is going to make a mark. And you know what? The prophet Simeon comes through when he looks at Mary on the eighth day of the baby. When he presented in the temple, he said, this will be the sign of many to go down. This will be the sign of many who are going to be, you know, elated. But you are going to see all this, and a sword will pierce your heart. Why? Because that is exactly what Jesus is all about. Many people of the world do not want to hear the word. And that's why he said, three times I begged the Lord to release me from this. I asked the Lord, please, Lord, don't let me go in depression, because then the world is going to suffer. Don't let me give up on these people, because then your message is not going to make known. And listen to what the Lord said to him. You see, when you pray, God will talk to you. These words are not Saint Paul. These words are God. Listen to this. My grace is sufficient for you, for power is made perfect in weakness. I want you to be weak, he said to him, the Lord. Because when you preach the word, I do not want you to center on yourself. But I want you to center on me, the message. I don't want people to know Saint Paul. Because Paul made it clear to the Corinthians, you bunch of idiots. How many of you are after Peter? Because he is the head of the church. How many of you are with me because I preach the word to you? How many of you are with the priest because he is among you? Who was crucified for you? Peter, Paul, Apollo, but Jesus Christ. So your faith will be in Christ, because the priest is today, tomorrow he is gone. But he is yesterday, today, and forever. My dear people, this is what I tell you what St. Paul was all about. He was so full of Jesus. He was so full of his presence, of the grace within him, that he cannot remain silent. And that's why he said to us, his grace for me is enough. I am who I am with the grace of God. And then he continued, I will rather boast mostly gladly of my weakness. And we can say with him, I can do so too. How many times when I am in my office, or I am at peace, or quiet with myself, I said, how stupid I am to say what I said. What I did. How stupid I am to answer that phone. Maybe somebody was dying, like this morning at 5:30. You know, we have a phone call for somebody who died. And when I answered, I said, I will be there. How many times the Lord is testing us, even in those early hours and sometimes, you know, difficult times. And sometimes we don't want to give to the Lord, because our comfortability is more important than him. In order that the power of Christ might dwell within me. And that's why the weakness was in him. So the power is not in Paul as a person, but the message. And that's why he said, I come trembled in front of you. I plead Jesus and him crucified. For the Jews is a scandal, for the Gentile is a folly. But for us who believe, Jesus Christ is the power of God. And that's why St. Paul recognized that when he come to preach this word, people are going to say, we believe in a king. You crazy? We believe in a king with power. We believe in somebody who has a future. Who is he? A criminal on the cross. And you want us to believe in him, that in him alone there is salvation, when there was no even rescue from his death? And St. Paul said, yes, I come to you terrified and trembling to preach Christ to you. Because for the Jews that was a scandal to die on the cross. For those who have philosophy like the Greeks and take with their logic, they see as a folly to believe in something. somebody who is a failure. But for us to believe, Jesus Christ is the power of God. And that's why St. Paul continued, I am content with weakness. Why? Because with the insult and hardship and persecution and constraint, here comes the answer. For the sake of Christ, for when I am weak, I am very strong. So dear people, when you feel very weak, especially in front of people who try to put you down as a believer, at that very moment, if you are in touch with God, and God is in touch with you through prayer, you will find words in your heart. And God will say them to your lips that sometimes you don't know that you are saying them. Because it's not you who speak, but I speak through you. But we have to have a union with Him. How many times we go from Sunday to Sunday without even stop for 5 minutes to say a prayer? How many of us, before we came to Mass, we opened the scriptures at home, and that's why we published them in the bulletin, the readings, so that you have a Bible and you can follow them and read them before you come here. How can you receive the message and reinforce the message if you don't know what the prophet is saying, what St. Paul is saying, what Jesus intends to say at the gospel? And that's why I say to you, we will have a vibrant church, we will have a dynamic church, if you invest time in the Word. Because the Word makes us part of the message of Christ, and we become one with Him, with His grace, to bring conversion and change the heart of people around us. And even when we are weak, with all our shortcomings, with all our big mouths, with all our temper, with all our infirmities, we know that people say, I believe. Because His actions speak more louder than His mouth. Because that is really what really is all about today. The actions of the people, when they reject Jesus, He said, I am astonished of the love of faith you have. And St. Paul said, yes, in that weakness, when we are about to throw the towel, there is the power of Christ come true. And God will never put you down and let you go in the mouth of the lions. Remember, dear people, that the message of Christ is not the message of the world. And the people of the world is not going to welcome you, including your mother, including your father, including your brothers. I'm not talking about strangers. Go and talk to your brother about faith. He said, please, I don't want to hear it. Because when we are comfortable in sin, and that sin is part of our integrity of life, the word of Scripture is something that we don't want to hear. Because that word of Scripture really comes like weapons and try to take our heart and change it, and we resist the word. So when we don't go to Bible study, when we don't invest our time in Scripture, and when we talk about the priest, we talk long at Mass, you're not going to grow, dear people. Growth comes only from the word of God. And that's why it was written, for our instruction, for our teaching, for our, as we say, endurance, for our really building up. And sometimes even we have to put down what is not belong to Christ. And I ask you to really don't give up. Your faith is precious. God gave you that faith because He loved you dearly. From the fount of baptism, He gave you a message. And that message is to go out and to make Him known. So that when we go in front of Him, we are not going to look strangers, but we are going to look like His laborers in His field. And He will say to us, good and faithful follower, I gave you 2 talents, and you made 4. I gave you 5, and you made 10. Enter now the kingdom of heaven. In weakness, we are strong. In that very notion of St. Paul, we need to understand that at that very moment when the devil is doing all his best to destroy our faith, at that very moment the grace of God comes, and He comes with one condition, if we have accepted Christ as he is, the Son of the living God.